A lot of people worldwide are unaware that they have high levels of stress hormone, cortisol. Having high cortisol over a longer period of time can have lasting negative effects on your health. In today's video, we'll talk about the signs and symptoms of high cortisol. Cortisol, also known as the stress hormone, is produced in the adrenal gland. These are two small glands that sit on top of the kidneys. Cortisol plays a variety of roles in your body, including regulating inflammation, controlling your sleep-wake cycle, regulating your blood sugar, blood pressure, and fight and flight response. And lastly, it regulates the way your body converts proteins, carbohydrates, and fats into usable energy. Your body continuously monitors your cortisol levels to maintain steady levels. Higher than normal or lower than normal cortisol level can be harmful to your health. Number one is weight gain around your abdomen or stomach. This is one of the most common signs of high cortisol. The muscles in your buttocks and your thighs starts to waste away, but your belly starts to get bigger. You often see this in older people, especially men over age of 50, where their legs become extremely thin, yet they get a buildup of hanging fat around the stomach. This is due to high cortisol breaking down the muscle proteins in the legs and turning it into sugar to give you energy. Then insulin is converting the new sugar from your blood into the belly fat. You also get fatty deposits or buffalo hump on your upper neck. You also get a round, puffy moon face. Number two is sleeping problems. If you wake up in the middle of the night with an overactive mind, this is a sign that you have too much cortisol. You might find it very hard to get back to sleep because your brain is overthinking, trying to make plans and solve problems when you should be resting. This is because cortisol controls your internal clock or circadian rhythm, and too much of it affects your sleep and keeps you alert. Also, not getting enough sleep can lead to fatigue or tiredness. Number three is high blood pressure. Stress causes high blood pressure by raising cortisol. If your body and brain thinks that you are in danger, it will release cortisol, which in turn will trigger release of adrenaline to increase blood flow and energy. This happens so that you can be able to run or fight when in danger. This is a normal response. However, if you suffer from long-term stress, this puts a lot of pressure on your blood vessels and keeps your blood pressure high and increases the risk of heart diseases and stroke. If you're finding this information useful at all, please hit the like, subscribe button, and turn your notification on to stay updated with my latest health-related tips. Number four is sexual dysfunction. Cortisol levels that are too high can cause sexual dysfunction. When cortisol is being overproduced, the sex hormones are not being produced in their usual quantities, which can lead to irregular periods, fertility issues, decreased libido, and erectile dysfunction. Number five has to do with your skin. High cortisol levels can cause wide red or purple stretch marks on your thighs, abdomen, chest, and arms. It can also cause easy bruising, excessive hair growth in women, and acne. Number six is neurological symptoms. High cortisol level can cause anxiety, confusion, concentration and memory loss, depression, suicidal thoughts, panic attacks, and irritability. Number seven is effects on your immune system. Since cortisol works to decrease stress-induced inflammation, it also weakens the immune system, which can make you more susceptible to infection. When the body has high cortisol, the high level interferes with the production of anti-inflammatory substances called cytokines, and this causes decreased wound healing. Number eight is bone and muscle weakness. High cortisol can cause osteoporosis and fractures because it reduces calcium absorption, bone, and collagen formation. Also, cortisol decreases amino acid uptake by muscles, which inhibits protein formation. This means you won't build muscles as well, which leads to muscle weakness in the upper arm and thighs. Cortisol also breaks down muscles and causes loss of protein in your thigh muscles and your buttocks. This can cause weakness and pain on your knees, especially when climbing stairs. Number nine is high blood sugar. Under normal circumstances, cortisol counterbalances the effects of insulin to regulate blood sugars. Cortisol raises blood sugar by releasing stored glucose, while insulin lowers blood sugar. Having chronically high cortisol levels can lead to persistent high blood sugars, which can lead to excessive thirst, excessive hunger, and frequent urination. If you have some or all of these signs and symptoms, you may need a cortisol test. You could get a blood test. For these, blood samples are usually taken twice during the day, once in the morning when the cortisol levels are at their highest, and again around 4 p.m. when the levels are much lower. You can also get a urine test. For the urine test, your doctor may ask you to collect all your urine during a 24-hour period, and you'll be given a special container and instructions for how to collect and store the urine sample. The third way of testing is using a saliva test. This is usually done at home with a kit to collect the saliva sample. Your healthcare provider will tell you what time to collect your sample. It's often done at night before you go to bed when cortisol levels are normally lower. High cortisol levels can be as a result of stress, pituitary gland issues, adrenal gland tumors, medications such as steroids, which are used to treat asthma, arthritis, or certain cancers. If this has been helpful, hit that like button and be sure to subscribe for more health-related videos. Until next time, stay healthy and remember, health is the greatest wealth.